this class you work out one problem on bus admittance matrix. Question is, form Y bus matrix and calculate the bus voltage V1 and V2. That is the question. This is the given diagram. The system consists of two current sources, three inductance, -J4, -J2, -J4, 4 angle 45 degrees, 4 angle 0. These two are in polar form. In rectangular form, 2.83 plus J 2.83, 4 plus J 0. Then next I convert into an equivalent voltage source. 4 into 4, 16, minus 45 degrees. 2 into 4, 8 angle minus 90 degrees. This is minus J4, this is minus J2, this is minus J4. Neglect line charging admittance. The system consists of two shunt capacitors. This is J20 per unit, this is J20 per unit. All the values are in per unit. First step, I have to form a Y bus. In the bus 1, 1, 2, 3 elements are connected. J20 minus J8. That is equal to minus J12. In this bus, 1, 2, 3 elements are connected. J20 minus J6. That is equal to J14. The element which is common to 1 and 2 is minus J4 into minus plus J4 plus J4. This is A, B, C, D. This is a Y bus matrix, a bus admittance matrix of this system. The second step, I have to find V1 and V2. I bus is equal to Y bus into V bus. Therefore, V bus is equal to Y bus inverse into I bus. So, this is V1, this is V2, this is E1 and E2. So, Y bus inverse, first I have to find 1 minus AD minus BC, D minus B minus EA. This is A, B, C, D. I substitute all the values. Y bus inverse is minus J.092, J.026, J.026, minus J.079. Here V1, V2 I have to find. This is a Y bus inverse matrix. Into 2.83 plus J2.83, 4 plus J0. Now I can easily find V1 and V2. V1 is equal to 0.303 angle minus 30.96 degrees. V2 is equal to 0.253 angle minus 107 degrees. In the same problem, I remove the capacitor and I add the shunt reactor, that is minus J20 per unit, here minus J20 per unit. The question is, form the Y bus matrix, find the bus voltage V1 and V2. First I have to form the Y bus matrix. In the bus 1, 3 elements are connected, minus J20, minus J4, minus J4, that is equal to minus J28. Bus 2, 3 elements are connected, minus J20, minus J2, minus J4, that is equal to minus J26. The element which is common to 1 and 2 is minus J4 into minus, therefore plus J4 plus J4. This is the Y bus matrix of this system. The second step, I have to find V1 and V2. So I bus is equal to Y bus into V bus. V bus is equal to Y bus inverse into I bus. Therefore, I have to take the inverse of this matrix. So, inverse of this matrix is 1 by AD minus BC, D minus B minus CA. This is A, B, C, D. I substitute all the values. The inverse matrix is J.037, J5.616 into 10 power minus 3, J5.616 into 10 power minus 3, J.039. So, this is V1, V2. This is Y bus inverse. This is current 2.83 plus J2.83, 4 plus J0. I can easily calculate V1 and V2. V1 is equal to 0.165 angle 129.58 degrees. V2 is equal to 0.173 angle 95.31 degrees. I will compare the results. In the first case, I add shunt capacitor in the bus 1 and bus 2. Same value. V1 is equal to 0.303 angle minus 30.96 degrees. V2 is equal to 0.253 angle minus 107 degrees. The second case, I add shunt reactor, that is minus J20, here minus J20. Here V1 is equal to 0.165 angle 129.58 degrees. V2 is equal to 0.173 angle 95.31 degrees. When I add shunt capacitor, the voltage is higher compared to the shunt reactor. This is the inference we obtained from this problem. With this, I conclude my lecture. Thanks for listening.